Now, it's the late, it's the test that can help people track down missing relatives, detect diseases and even unlock family secrets.
Yes, so no wonder 26 million people have taken a DNA test over the past decade. And in her latest documentary, DNA Family Secrets, journalist Stacey Dooley and one of the UK's leading geneticists, Professor Turi King, are helping people across the UK discover the mysteries hidden in their genetic code.
Just got one question. She's still alive. No.
She is.
She is?
No.
Your mum's still alive.
Oh, flippin' heck.
She lives in Ireland. She's in a care home. She's got dementia.
Oh.
But she's alive and they're looking after her.
Well, that was Stacey with Margaret there, who found out that her mum was still alive. Well, Professor Turi King, who helped track her mum down, joins us now. Good morning, Turi.
Good morning.
Good morning. That made me really emotional.
I mean, just that
little clip there. The show is so powerful and personal, as we just saw there with Margaret. I mean, it's incredible, isn't it, how much you can find out from someone's DNA.
It is. I mean, it's amazing, these tests and what you can do with them now. It can really help people solve family mysteries. So for Margaret, I mean, I tear up still watching that. And it's why Stacey's so good, because with her own history, or the fact that, you know, she didn't grow up with her biological father, she kind of really gets this. And the fact that people can have these deep sort of family mysteries, and you can help people now by saying something about where their ancestry is from, finding close relatives, finding missing relatives. It's really a powerful tool.
One of the things that we've learned in the last couple of episodes is apparently 1 in 50 people in the UK don't know who their biological father is. And I think that's one of the reasons that the story about Richard really hit home to so many. He was looking for his father. This is a remarkable story because we think that he's found his brother, but it's not his brother. Can you just explain the story a little bit for those who haven't seen it?
So this was a really interesting one. So Richard was actually contacted by somebody through Facebook who said, I think I'm actually your biological father. So the parents who Richard grew up with have already passed away. And he did a DNA test, found out that his sister was his half-sister. They didn't have the same father. And then he's contacted by this man who says, I think I'm your biological father. And by the way, I've got a son, which would make this chap, Brendan, his half-sibling. And so what we did was we did the genetic analysis to show whether or not these two were actually half-brothers. And I can't even begin to tell you how surprised we were to find out that they aren't.
Yeah, but they look... I was watching this thinking they must be brothers.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Oh. I mean, we all were. And I think that's one of the really important things about this program particularly, is that we show that actually DNA testing can have unexpected outcomes.
Right.
And I think that's actually really, really important, in that I know that, you know, some other television series, what they do is they'll start with sort of 100 people and then they'll narrow down. They'll show the ones that they really want to show. What we do is we choose the people at the beginning and we follow them all the way through their story.
Yeah.
And we are really privileged to be a part of that, because, you know, DNA testing sometimes doesn't show what you think it's going to show. You might get something quite unexpected. And I think that's, they are really, really courageous people to let us follow them on this journey.
Yeah, and of course, DNA tests can do so much more than just trace family members, can't it? Because we were talking about ovarian cancer. It's Ovarian Cancer Awareness Month this month. And DNA tests can actually help detect that and other serious life-threatening diseases as well, can't they?
Oh, absolutely. And this is where I would say don't go to these direct consumer testing companies. We have one of actually the best systems in the world in the NHS. If you've got anything in your family that you are concerned about, go to your GP, because there are tests that can look at things like, are you genetically predisposed towards things like breast cancer, ovarian cancer? We have Charlie, who finds out in the first episode that she's not the carrier of a version of the gene for Huntington's disease. It can be incredibly powerful, but a number of people actually, apparently up to about 80% of people, don't actually want to know. So again, very brave for these people to allow us to follow them on this journey.
And you mentioned, you just touched on it there, about there are companies that offer this sort of the DNA testing. I presume we have to be cautious with who we give our information to.
So in terms of DNA testing, it really depends on what your question is. So for things like determining ancestry, recent ancestry, or, you know, answering a family mystery, these direct-to-consumer testing companies are actually really, really good. The ones that try and tell you about things like health or fitness, for example, what they're looking at are genes that are associated with a particular thing. So, for example, are you going to be, you know, more of a sprinter, for example? But it's just a tiny, tiny part of the picture. There'll be more than one gene that's involved. It'll be things like, you know, training and what are you eating? Because, like, if you're sitting on the sofa eating donuts all day, you're not going to be sprinting anywhere.
Okay.
Although you should be.
Yeah, maybe you should. It's absolutely fascinating. Thank you so much for joining us, Professor Turi King. Thank you.
No problem.
And you can watch the amazing discoveries in the final instalment of DNA Family Secrets on BBC Two tonight at 9 p.m. or catch up with the whole series on BBC iPlayer.
If you haven't seen it, definitely catch up. It's brilliant.